गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड लेसन नंबर 2, द साउंड ऑफ म्यूजिक फर्स्ट पार्ट, एंड फ्रॉम द सेकेंड पार्ट वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड 4 पैराग्राफ्स. लेट वी स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट पैराग्राफ. नाउ एट द एज ऑफ 14, बिस्मिल्ला अकम्पनीड हिज अंकल टू द इलाहाबाद म्यूजिक कॉन्फ्रेंस. ही प्लेड शहनाई विद हिज अंकल. Now at the end of his recital, Ustad Fiaz Khan patted the young boy's back and said, "Work hard and you shall make it." Means they all appreciate. Now Ustad Fiaz Khan also appreciated Bismillah Khan at the age of 14 because his music was very great. Now when in All India Radio in Lucknow in 1938, Bismillah Khan's, there is a big break for Bismillah Khan's. Now he soon became an often heard Shehnai player on radio. Now when India gained independence on 15th August 1947, Bismillah Khan became the first Indian to greet the nation with his Shehnai. Now he poured his heart out into Raag Kafi from the Red Fort to an audience which included Mahatma Gandhi and Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. And after that, later, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru gave his famous Tryst with Destiny speech because he became the first Prime Minister of independent India. Now when Bismillah Khan was given many memorable performances both in India and abroad. His first trip abroad was to Afghanistan, where King Zahir Shah was so taken in by the maestro that he gifted him priceless Persian carpet and other souvenirs. Now the King of Afghanistan was not the only one to be fascinated with Bismillah Khan music. Film director Vijay Bhatt was so impressed after hearing Bismillah Khan play at the festival that he named a film after the instrument called Goonj Uthi Shehnai. Means Bismillah Khan music was so popular that the filmmaker also make films about their talent. Now Mr. Vijay Bhatt is also make a film Goonj Uthi Shehnai from the Bismillah Khan's music. Now the film was very hit and one of the Bismillah Khan's composition Dil Ka Khilona Hai Toot Gaya turned into be a nationwide chart buster. Means this song was very famous in all nation. Now Bismillah Khan's venture in film music were limited to two, Vijay Bhatt's Goonj Uthi Shehnai and Vikram Srinivas Kannada venture Sanadi Appanna, because he did not want to the glamour of the film because he thought that it was very artificial, so he never gone from the music. Now from awards and recognition came thick and fast. Means recently they got many awards, many prizes. The first Indian to be invited to perform at the prestigious Lincoln Center Hall in the United States of America, and the person is Bismillah Khan. He also took part in the World Exposition in Montreal in Cannes Art Festival and in Oscar Trade Fair. So well known did he become internationally that an auditorium in Tehran was named after him, Teher Mosque Ustad Bismillah Khan. Means he was world famous musician of Shehnai. Now national award like Padma Shri, Padma Bhushan and Padma Vibhushan were conferred on him. Means all these awards was given to him. In 2001, the award, India's highest civilian award, the Bharat Ratna, was awarded to him. Now he coveted award resting on his chest and his eyes glittering with rare happiness. He said, "All I would like to say is, teach your children music. This is Hindustan's richest tradition. Even the West is now coming in to learn our music." So this was the speech of him that he given to when he get the highest civilian award, the Bharat Ratna. Now in spite of having traveled all over the world, Khan Saab, as he fondly called as, Bismillah Khan is also called as Khan Saab, he called, is excitedly fond of Banaras and Damra, Dumraon and they remained for him the most wonderful towns of the world. He always told about that Banaras and Dumraon was his most wonderful towns of the world and he never gone beyond him there. A student of his once wanted him to head a Shehnai school in USA and the student promised to recreate the atmosphere of Banaras by replicating the temples there. But Khan Saab asked him if he would be able to transport River Ganga as well. Later he is remembered to have said that is why whenever I am in foreign country I keep yearning. Means he didn't want to go across the River Ganga. He did not want to cross the River Ganga and go to the world. Now Ustad Bismillah Khan's life is perfect example of rich cultural heritage of India. One of the effortlessly accept that the devout Muslim like him, he can naturally pay the Shehnai every morning at the Kashi Vishwanath temple. He personified real secularism. He was a practicing Muslim who offered namaz 5 times a day. Yet he had immense faith in Baba Vishwanath, Sankat Mochan Hanuman and Ganga Maiya. A devotee of Nath Brahma and an embodiment of Ganga Jamuni Tehzeeb. Now he was a shining symbol of Indian secularism. Shehnai Maestro Ustad was so liberal and great in his area of activities that he defied description. Now throughout his life he abided by the principle that all religion are one. He was a devotee of Saraswati. He did not go abroad in search of greener pastures. So students, your homework is to read all the paragraphs of the part 2 from where the Shehnai of Bismillah Khan, and we know about the life of Bismillah Khan, which is the path for the new generation, ki how he played a role of a personified real secularism man. Thank you.